Hello students, my name is Sumit Mehta. So in today's lecture, we will discuss about fission and budding, which are also the types or modes of reproduction used by single organisms. So first we will discuss about what is fission. Okay, so fission is only for unicellular organisms. Cellular means having a single cell organisms, cell division or fission leads to the creation of new individuals. So many different patterns of fission have been observed. Many bacteria and protozoa simply split into two equal halves during cell division. So now we will discuss about the cell division in amoeba. So let's say this is an amoeba with the nucleus inside it. Okay. So what happens is this nucleus grows and tends to split. So it finally is and then it split into two another amoeba. So this is called as students, this is the binary fission in, why it is called binary fission in amoeba? It is amoeba, okay, single amoeba. And they are producing two separate amoeba, so it is binary. And the fission is when one individual create two individuals, it is called as fission reaction. Okay, so this is all about fission in amoeba. So now let's discuss about the budding. So now students, this is also a type of modes of reproduction used by single organisms. Okay, so what happens in budding is organisms such as Hydra use regenerative cells for reproduction. Regenerative means the cell that can produce regenerative cells for reproduction in the process of budding. So what happens is, let me draw a Hydra. Okay, so these are the arms. So this is a Hydra type, and a bud develops as an outgrowth. Okay, so this was the Hydra. Okay, so here a bud develops. This is a bud. This bud develops as an outgrowth due to the repeated cells division at one specific site. These buds develop and produce a similar Hydra, okay, on one side. So this is called as budding in Hydra students. Okay, so I hope now that you are pretty clear about the fission and the budding. And in the next lecture students, we will discuss about vegetation propagation and spore formation. Okay, so stay tuned for the next lecture on vegetation propagation and spore formation.